Welcome to Hannon CAD Learning Channel. Today we are going to start lesson number 1 on Femap software. In the first example, we will explore the buckling load of a single cantilever under a concentrated cantilever load. On this video, it will be interesting to the main new user because I will perform all the manipulation that need to be done to perform this calculation. It's necessary to import a neutral file for this. Go to File and Import Neutral File and you select Bracket. We see a neutral file does not contain geometric objects but contains only lines. First of all, you need to create boundary surface in order to split this model into finite elements. For this we go in the diameter of the geometry boundary surface and from curve. Select four lines that form one limited surface and press OK. Next step, select the other four lines that form the second boundary surface. In order to highlight the objects that you have selected, you can click here this button and check press OK. Boundaries is displayed in such green color that is in this case it is no longer a set of some lines but two surfaces. We can split these surfaces into finite elements, but first of all you need to create the properties of the model. We will select the types of finite elements, we will set the material, and in this case since we are breaking it into plate finite element, we will also set the thickness of this element in order to create the property. Go to Model and Property, or a similar operation can be performed through the project tree. You can open Model and right-click on Property and select New. In order to select a new material, click on the button next to the material, or you can select a material from the list, but in this case we have not created any material yet, so click to create a new material here. I will load the material from the standard library which is set above. For this I press load button and select steel. I press OK, then I press OK, and I see that I have created a material here, and then I need to set the thickness for the plate finite elements. The new window defines the properties for the plate element type, that is for plate finite element. If you want to use some other types of finite elements, then you need to click on the Property Type Element button and select the default element you need. Here we set the thickness to 0.1 and press OK, and immediately the company offer us to create a second property with it too. We don't need it, we press Cancel. And now in the project tree, if we open the material and property, we will see the material that we have created, and in the property we see the plate finite element. Now it's necessary to split out two boundary surfaces into a mesh of finite element. But before that you need to set the size of this element. In order to set the size, go to Mesh and Mesh Control and Size on Surface. Select two surfaces with ID 1 and 2. You can also highlight it to check the correct choice and press OK. And in this case I will set the element size to 0.3 and press OK and cancel. In order to display the number of elements on each curve, You need to go to the View Style toolbar and Mesh Size. To display exactly the number, press F6. In the Label category, Entities and Color. In Options, select Curve Mesh Size and set Symbole and Count and press OK. And now we have the number of finite elements on each of the curves. And now we need to split two surfaces into a mesh. For this we go to Mesh and Geometry and Surface. Select the first surface and press OK. OK, here we are promoted to select the property that we will split. Leave the settings by default and press OK. To call the previous command, you can right-click and select Previous Command and select the second surface and press OK. And here I will already use the More option button. Let's talk about Connect Edge Nodes. By default, this option is enabled and it stitches nodes that are within the specific tolerance. So if I am now with the option enabled, I will split the second surface into finite elements, then the nodes of this element will automatically refer to the nodes of the element that are on the first surface. I will disable this option now in order to show two tools for checking the finite element model for the congruence of nodes. Press OK. So this situation occurs quite often when you need to check or you have node that match. We press F5 key dot and in the view select in model style select free edge and press OK. In order to visualize which nodes we have are not together, you can use the command tools and check and coincident nodes. Select all and press OK and leave the default settings and press OK. Press F5 key and return to standard draw model and press OK. Now we need to create load and constraint. For this, go to model and constraint and create a manage set. Click new constraint set and enter a name, for example Hannon set, and press OK and press done. In the constraint section, we have a set of fixing. We go to model and constraint and nodal. We select method on the curves to select two curved nodes we want to fix and press OK and press OK. Then you need to set the load. We go in model and load and nodal and give the title and select the node that we want to set the force and press OK. Select force by component and along the axis of the global coordinate system, we set the value to 100 and press OK. To reverse the vector, we press F6 key and select load vector and select reverse and press OK. Now we run our analysis buckling of this design. We go model and analysis, create a new analysis and select NX nastran solver and change the type of analysis from static to 7 buckling and click OK and press analysis and wait. In order to visualize the results, we right-click on the graphic window and select Post Data, and we change the contour to Total Translation and press OK. and in order to visualize the results, press F5 key and in deform style select deform set and in contour style select contour and press OK. So we are shown the form of buckling and that the buckling of the bracket is considered complex. There is a link of description under the video and you can also write any comments and I will try to answer them all. Thanks for your attention and subscribe to our channel.